tournament now, I would say that it's important for either team to win this, because Wildcard Gaming have a good shot at overthrowing Method Black for top point earners and getting a spot at BlizzCon that way. So if they lose here, they basically lose any opportunity to catch up, unless Method Black just go on a huge slump, which I think is probably never going to happen. But Choccy Milkman as well, their only hope of really qualifying is to get first place at the LAN. So BlizzCon is effectively on the line in this series in the lower bracket, just in the first cup.
Blizzo, Looney used Transcendence very early on, a very aggressive push here by Choccy Milkman. They haven't really committed too much of their offense yet. It's a decent crowd control change, but mostly just negated by the Transcendence. Now Gelu in a little bit of trouble as he used some of his Shimmers to move in. Cockroach Asphyxiate stun. That's going to be an Iron Bar coming in from Clyde to try to deny some of that damage. Icy Veins gets pulled out. This is a touch of death as well. Both teams looking to get very aggressive early on. Looney caught into a blind. Blizzo in some trouble, but he pre-grapple weaponed the kidney shot. Really nicely done there by Blizzo.
Beautifully done. Still in trouble. He cannot afford to throw away in the Grand Arena. The blind pick, they can't afford it. They stun up Looney during his ability to cast uninterrupted. Denying it for now, but not going for the counterspell. Cyclone at low health, making this even more difficult for Wildcard Gaming to recover. Z-Pi has Ratcher snared up in those chains of ice. He's having a hard time making it back to his target. Ring of Peace now really making it difficult. Blizzo tries to reconnect with Gelu. Gelu blinks. Blizzo reconnects. Z-Pi stunned away, but then walks into a double leg sweep. Blizzo leading the charge. Gelu respects it, using the Glider's Medallion Temporal Shield, soaking up all this damage. Likely to heal back, but the Glider's Maledict is absorbing some of it. Big attack now on Blizzo. Looney sees it coming. Trades the Life Cocoon to absorb the hits and allow Blizzo to continue his pursuit. Desperately looking for an early ice block, but Iron Bark available. I think it's unlikely.
Yeah, I think Gelu's going to be able to hold on. Paralysis, though, comes in, slowing down some of that healing. Gelu could be in some trouble. Iron Bark will deflect that attack, and I think Gelu will be able to survive. And for Windwalker Death Knight, what we've seen in the past is basically two major check marks they have to go through in order to get that ice block, and that is going to be Temporal Shield, and then, of course, the Iron Bark. So there's a small window here where they could burst down Gelu, but there's good pressure here onto Blizzo. Looney caught into the Polymorph, and that's one of the things about the Mistweaver Monk is they don't have the best ability to defend themselves from incoming crowd control, from the Mage and the Restoration Druid, and they can get caught up in these extended crowd control chains. Luckily, Looney will be able to keep his team alive. Gelu, in the meantime, taking quite a bit of burst damage. It could fall. There's an interrupt on the Clyde. Gelu, no Temporal Shield, no Iron Bark. And there it is. There's the Ice Block. This is what Blizzo and Z-Pi have to do consistently in this matchup. And they have a decent pressure on the Blizzo, but they haven't been able to force out any major defensives.
Smooth moves from Wildcard Gaming. One Ice Block out of the way. Touch of Death available, and could maybe easily force the second one shortly. Double leg sweep, touch of death. Are they going for a swap? No, it's on Gelu. His Fists of Fury are amplifying that touch of death damage. That red icon above Gelu's head about to explode for a big hit. Clyde denies it actually entirely with a Swift Men timing right before it explodes, totally saving the day and denying potential ice block force or kill there. Good response by Clyde, but his mana is not looking too healthy. Wildcard Gaming are doing a lot of damage.
Whoa!
Coming very close to killing Gelu, and even though they don't, it's at the expense of Clyde's mana, unless he can find a drink, and against an Unholy Death Knight, it's very difficult to drink. Wildcard Gaming are in a commanding lead.
Yeah, Wildcard Gaming's been doing a good job. Clyde's mana going lower and lower at this point of the game. You have to wonder, at what point does Choccy Milkman sort of abandon this offensive push? They're looking for an all-in on the Looney. Grapple Weapon comes in once again. There's the double leg sweep. Big damage by Blizzo. Are they going to be able to take down Ratcher? He's already used his trinket. Fane has been traded out as well. Looney does manage to sneak away and survive, but Wildcard Gaming, they're all over the place. Ratcher could fall, Gelu could fall. Clyde also not completely out of it yet if he plays too aggressive. Mana sort of evening out at this point, but I really feel like Looney, as the game goes on, is going to develop more and more of a lead.
Way of the Crane. Looney's trying to add some extra damage. It's a race against Temporal Shield's clock. Can they get the ice block? They're still going through it, despite it now being over. They whiffed the leg sweep on Gelu, unfortunately only hitting Ratcher. Gelu looks like he should be all right, but now they're actually switching to Looney. He saw it coming. What a read. I can't believe he saw it. He would be dead right now if he did not activate that fortifying elixir right before being stunned. So Looney anticipating an attack on himself and blocking it preemptively, denying the kill there for the Choccy Milkman. Gelu now on the back foot. Iron Bark is exchanged to reduce the damage on Gelu, but so difficult for him to recover. Where are the openings? Looney's trinket is coming up in 15 more seconds. Blizzo has his entire defensive lineup. Z-Pi is more than healthy. This is looking better and better for Wildcard Gaming. Clyde stunned up. This could be an ice block. They stun Blizzo. They stall for just a tad bit longer. This temporal shield isn't going to be too big. Looney gets counterspelled. Maybe an opportunity. Clyde's moving across the map. Maybe looking for a cyclone at low health. Fakes the dark simulacrum. Now Gelo's still low. Interrupted on Frost for one more second. Ice block. Nope. Wildcard Gaming take game one.
That was a very quick loop. It looked very close.
I actually think Firestarter in this composition, the ability, basically it's a talent, where every time you fireball, it reduces the cooldown of your combustion by 5 seconds. That allows you to get those big meteor one-shots off way more consistently in a matchup like this, and that's the kind of build I hope that he's running.
Looney crowd controlled right off the bat. Blizzo anticipating an attack, activating that fortified elixir. And then transcendencing out of the fight.
Combustion.
They're going to go after Zepi. No. Who is this greater pyroblast on? On nobody. Gets shut down, and Gelu is trying to bake up a spicy greater pyro. If at any moment he can finish one of those, it does 35% of someone's health, but it's a very long casted spell. So if Gelu does manage to find one and his team can back him up with some follow-up, it could almost immediately be the end of a player's life. So definitely keep your eyes on Gelu. Although making a bit of a mistake there, blinking on top of Mystic and then getting both players stunned, they definitely need to focus on their positioning a bit more. Gelo was unable to get follow-up crowd control, and as a result, Mystic's Lightning Lasso is totally negated on Blizzo.
Yeah, that was a really weird start from Gelo, I have to be honest. He was going for greater pyroblast, and then he popped Combustion when they didn't even have a stun, and I don't know, just a bit strange, but we'll have to see what exactly can happen. Looney now completely free casting, is able to keep Blizzo and Zepi completely healthy. Gelu is playing greater pyroblast and he's been going for them consistently in this matchup, but I don't know if it's the best choice. I mean, baiting out a lot of interrupts, we can land the greater pyroblast, that's going to be great. Blizzo does force get that life cocoon from Luna to keep him alive in this situation, but Gelu's been taking a lot of damage. Blizzo uses the touch of karma, blessing and protection on that touch of karma. Now Blizzo is very vulnerable. And that's one of the downsides against playing against a Holy Paladin. He has the Fortifying Brew, opting not to trade it out just yet, but if now's not a good time to use it, I don't know when is. Looney finally out of crowd control, able to reconnect with Blizzo, and Blizzo was able to hold on to that Fortifying Brew, but a nice counterspell coming in from Gelu. Very offensive plays from the Choccy Milkmen. I was saying, before I was rudely interrupted by that nice play, that Clyde is actually a little bit behind on mana here in the situation. So I think the Wildcard Gaming can kind of hold on. They could win this game on mana.
Usually you don't compliment someone when they interrupt you, but it's okay. Gelu's still in trouble. Clyde needs some big heals, but he doesn't have many cooldowns to work with. So Gelu's ice block could be forced here momentarily. It's a race. Can they get through that temp shield in time? No, he's still holding out at about 50% health. I'm not sold on this Fire Mage Elemental Shaman composition. I'm also not really sold on the map. I mean, maybe they were trying to win on mana, but they're not. So it's obvious that they are inexperienced with this composition. Gelu has to ice block, major defensive cooldown out of the way, and they continue to fall further behind in every regard.
I just feel like the way you play this composition is you go after the healer. Like, I think Looney's just such a vulnerable target. They could do consistent setups on him, allow Mystic to sort of really harass him in this matchup. And Gelu could have free reign, Dragon Breath Sheeps, Ring of Frost on the DPS of Blizzo and Zepi, but they're not opting to play it that way. Ultimate Sacrifice comes in from Clyde. Gelu's still taking a little bit of damage, manages to find one greater Power Blast on Blizzo. He hightails it out of there. He'll use his Transcendence to top off, and now it's Gelu in trouble once again.
Yeah, once again in trouble. Clyde with limited mana, basically no cooldowns for 3 more seconds, hoping that he can make it to that Avenging Wrath. Otherwise, Wildcard Gaming are going to put them on match points. Okay, now with Avenging Wrath, Clyde can activate that, increases healing so much so that it's unlikely that Wildcard Gaming will find a kill, unless they can crowd control him. So that is one way to eliminate that healing cooldown's potency. Looney's moving forward. They've crowd controlled Clyde. They're pushing for the win. How is Clyde going to respond to this crowd control? He's going to use Glaive's Medallion to remove it. Hammer of Justice Looney, pop Avenging Wrath, boost his healing, and get a huge heal to save Gelu. So good response from Clyde. But even still, Gelu just taking a beating. Tons of damage. Clyde is struggling just to sustain Gelu's life. This is very surprising during the Avenging Wrath. Ring of Frost defensively may not be enough. I am startled by the amount of damage that is currently tossed Gelu's way, but Clyde has managed to hold on.
Yeah, has managed to hold on, but at what cost? He's down to 15% mana. Divine Favor, Avenging Wrath will keep Gela afloat. Gela now looking for a Greater Power Boss once again, but like I said, I just can't help but feel like the Greater Power Boss is not the best option in this matchup, but might be able to get the miracle play and take down ZPI. Unfortunately, gets interrupted. There's just so much disruption from Blizzo and ZPI in this matchup. Gela's going to be kiting away with the Blessing of Freedom, but they're all over him, and Clyde is running out of time. There's not much mana left to work with. Gela could easily fall. Blessing of Protection, one of the last line of defenses to keep Gela alive. Now looking for another Greater Power Blast. Is he going to be able to land? Ring of Peace denies. Nicely done by Looney.
Yeah, beautiful denial there. Fortunately for Clyde, his cooldowns are actually cycling quite efficiently. He's almost always had at least one answer during these pushes, but it's really his mana that's starting to hurt. And an Unholy Death Knight, that being ZPI, can just stop him from drinking so readily and so easily that I think they're just going to inevitably lose on mana. We haven't even gotten to dampening. They need a miracle. There's basically every defensive cooldown for Wildcard Gaming. Of course, Greater Power Blast is a miracle creator, so Gelu could put the team on his back, but it seems like there's a bit of inexperience on the roster in terms of this composition. Maybe they're anticipating to win on mana, but they actually lose on mana, and their setups have been kind of, I would say, sloppy at best, really, at this point. They need to try and mix something up here, because at this point, they're just banging their heads against a wall.
Yeah, they're definitely not playing it the way I thought they would in this matchup. Gelu, under a lot of pressure right now, does manage to get a Greater Power Blast off. Are they going to get the one-shot kill onto Blizzo? That would have been a disaster. Blizzo does manage to escape with the Diffuse Magic. Transcendence, Looney tops him off. Gelu looking for the hero play off the back of that Greater Power Blast and the Combustion. They're going to need a miracle at this point. That might have been it, but Blizzo with the cheat death does manage to survive. Looney just has to be careful. He's got Trinket, he's got the Life Cocoon, he's got the tools that he needs, as well as the Anti-Magic Zone. We have to see them use these buttons. Ooh. They want to hold on.
Nope, no Greater Power Blast there. I was wondering if that was just going to be the end of the game, but now Gelu is falling behind. Clyde is running out of options. Avenging Wrath is about to end. He gets one more big heal before its healing boosting effects are going to subside, and when they do, he's actually got a Blessing Protection in 3 seconds. Clyde is playing this out masterfully with his cooldowns. He's always had at least one answer, even though he's very low on mana. Gelu in trouble, but then has Ice Block again, so perhaps this game is being flipped on its head. Blizzo in a bit of trouble as two players are stunned on the team, working their way through a Gladiator's Medallion, which is exactly the main objective that they needed to get. The next Lightning Lasso could end Blizzo's life if Looney isn't careful. Gelu setting up some defensive polymorphs, looking for the Greater Pyroblast, trying to fake cast the Mind Freeze, looking for a Greater Pyroblast while Blizzo is hexed, then gets interrupted. A bit unfortunate that that hex ended prematurely. Gelu looking for more polymorphs, gets one onto Looney. This could be a big opportunity to kill Blizzo. Stormkeeper from Mystic, gigantic lightning bolts flying. Blizzo sees that, Transcendence is away. Looney follows him, manages to stabilize. Gelu falling behind, but Clyde still has answers. So long as he can keep casting Holy Lights and trade cooldowns, Gelu will hang on for a substantial amount of time. Divine Shield overlapped a bit with Ice Block. I believe he wanted to go for crowd control with that Divine Shield, but usually you would see Divine Shield Blessing of Sacrifice, not Divine Shield and Ice Block. So this is now finally some cooldown mismanagement from the side of the Choccy Milkman, and a big opening for Wildcard Gaming.
Yeah, definitely. Gelu gets interrupted, looking for a Greater Power Boss. Ring of Peace denies the follow-up. Clyde completely tapped on mana. Blessing of Protection is the only thing he really has left. Blizzo might have to be a little bit careful right now. Looney still has a healthy amount of mana, but Gelu, he has the Combustion available. They could go for the one shot, one opportunity onto Blizzo. That's going to be the Anti-Magic Zone, and that is exactly what we needed to see from ZPI, and that will keep Blizzo alive. Very nicely done. Things are looking good for Wildcard Gaming.
All right, Mystic has his Fire Elemental in the fight. He's got Stormkeeper rolling. He can do a lot of damage if Blizzo isn't careful. One Lightning Bolt. Where's the sec? Two Lightning Bolts. Touch of Karma. Going to trade to actually cut through it. Blizzo is in a bit of a tough situation. Gelu seems to be all right with Blessing of Protection, although he's very low. Temporal Shield about to go off. Maybe he's not all right. Clyde is just totally tapped on mana at this point. He's in crowd control. Gelu's trying to pull off the miracle while his team basically has nothing left to work with. It's a race to the finish here now at 24% dampening. Two members on Choccy Milkman are low. Clyde has zero mana to heal either of them, but Blizzo really doesn't have any options. But Gelu's looking like he's going to fall first. Fist of Fury flying, and Gelu Baba dying. Wildcard Gaming move to match point.
Yep, Wildcard Gaming. It was a close call a couple
because so often we see these Windwalkers kind of
teleport away on 10% HP or so, where if you have a couple of judgments, a couple of holy shocks, you can easily take that person down.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're on match point of potentially the last game of the first cup of the European region. Wildcard Gaming, they're looking stellar on this Windwalker, Death Knight, Mistweaver, but they have one more composition to beat, and that is the Holy Paladin Fire Mage Assassination Rogue. They're going all in. They have popped every aggressive cooldown, Combustion and Vendetta. If they don't even get a touch of Karma here, that is devastating for the Choccy Milkman. They're pushing for it, but they're not getting it. Ring of Peace protecting Blizzo at the corner of these Dalaran Sewer boxes. Maybe the map is going to backfire. Fortunately, though, they can just use Blessing of Protection to remove that Touch of Karma, so even though they didn't get it here, they could get it later on and then just remove its effect. Now Blizzo is trying to force some pressure with that Touch of Death, but not able to stay on target. Zipai is leading the charge, but he's polymorphed far away. Blizzo is on the run and playing this overly cautious. I don't blame him. I mean, the Choccy Milkman have blown every cooldown. Just survive for a bit and then go for a push, and you basically got the series in the bag, and that's what they're doing. They're making a push here. Vlad's crowd controlled on his Avenging Wrath. If they can get Ice Block and Avenging Wrath, that's a big deal. Big Holy Light, no stop on it. Nice timing. Clyde then moves in, gets crowd control. Blizzo is at low health. Dragon's Breath on the two members. Gelu now being reversed on. Clyde gets interrupted by Zipai. Clutch interrupt, goes for another one. Clyde fake casts the second. Ring of Peace protects Blizzo, but they Blessing of Protection off the Touch of Karma. If they can keep Looney out of the fight, Blizzo will be in a lot of trouble. They need to keep this chain going a bit longer. Sap is ended, they've silenced. They have no more follow-up. Life Cocoon available. Unlikely that we see him go down. Blizzo and Looney kiting and avoiding the push. But now there's no real response. Combustion available again. The next push could close this out.
Really nicely done by Blizzo. He's doing a great job. He's relocated his port with Looney in this situation, rotating through his defensive cooldowns, not overreacting to the situation. I really like how Wildcard Gaming is playing it so far. Gelu, of course, has this combustion available. It's going to be a lot of damage. A life cocoon actually gets kind of preemptively traded out there by Looney. I don't know how much trouble Blizzo was really in. I mean, there's no Vendetta, there's no combustion. Now, that's not going to be a lifeline that they have moving forward. Although Blizzo now, with his Fortifying Brew, with his Diffused Magic, should be feeling relatively safe. Gelu's the one that's in trouble. Leg sweep over onto Clyde. He's got no trinket. Could be the Ice Block, and surely it will be. Looney now into a full blind, but Blizzo preemptively reading the situation, using the Fortifying Brew to avoid a lot of this incoming damage, and now it's still Gelu on the back foot.
This is where the concern comes in. Choccy Milkman, their win condition is just winning in the start of the match. What happens when they don't win at the start of the match? Can they keep extending the fight on and win deeper into dampening? I'm starting to think that it's unlikely, so they're on match point. They didn't win with the aggressive strategy, so now they're kind of just left floundering around, hoping for a miracle to happen. Maybe they can do it. They pop Combustion. Blizzo just immediately going to be using Touch of Karma. I mean, that's a 2-for-1 exchange value on that defensive cooldown with Vendetta and Combustion committed at the same time. And perhaps the Choccy Milkmen are too predictable? We'll have to find out. Blizzo is still low on health, and Looney is now able to reconnect. Ring of Peace prevents the Rogue Ratcher from connecting. Although they're double Dragon's Breath, maybe they can do it on 1% health. He gets Life Cocooned. This Absorb, the only thing keeping Blizzo alive. Looney's now finally out of crowd control. No counterspell. Should be able to cast some Soothing Mists. And now he's trying to avoid Polymorph. Line of Sight's hit around the corner. Zipai Death Grips Gelu into a double stun. Blizzo setting up for the win here. Big Touch of Death. Clyde looks to deny it, but is he running Ultimate Sacrifice?
Nope.
Doesn't look like it, so maybe some potential to still kill Gelu. Clyde moves in, desperately to try and close the game out with Hammer of Justice. Gelu is trying to blink in Line of Sight for Polymorph, but he can't get there. Now he's in trouble. This is still match point for the Choccy Milkman, and they face elimination.
Blizzo a little bit vulnerable here still. Looney with no trinket. I think there's a full blind going to be available. I don't think Looney actually trinketed out of the blind. Clyde now caught into a leg sweep. Gelu retreating back to his Paladin, but Zipai, Blizzo, they're all over him. Blessing of Freedom should be enough with that Frost Nova to keep Gelu alive just a little bit longer. What is Rasher going to do? Who's he going after? Blizzo's still the most vulnerable target in this matchup. We have not entered dampening, and both these teams have been putting out a lot of pressure. Polymorph onto Zipai. He has the anti-magic zone if they really need it, but Looney in a prime position right now to keep Blizzo alive. Rapture moving forward. I think he wants to get the blind. If he can get it, there's an interrupt. It would be perfect to get the blind out of that interrupt. That's an extended crowd control chain. Blizzo, he might have to use his transcendence and escape, but pressure's just not there. And they actually go for a swap on Looney. Anti-magic zone gets traded out. Looney actually preemptively life cocooned Blizzo, which was a bit of a misread there in that situation. Gelu did not commit his combustion, and anti-magic zone was used as well as life cocoon. There's definitely openings here for Choccy Milkman.
Yep, despite not finding their main win condition, which is just killing the opposing team in the first couple of seconds, they are still scrambling together some semblance of opportunity.
Trouble.
10 seconds away for Looney's Flyer's Medallion. He needs to avoid Ratcher. Ratcher gets Blessing of Freedom. Ring of Peace prevents the reconnect for now. Ratcher Cloak of Shadows to immune the knockback to get the stun, but can't connect. Multiple Gladiator's Maledicts incoming. Looney pre-fortified Brew this incoming attack, soaking up all the hits, then transcendencing back to the pillar. Gets counterspelled, though, by Gelu. If Ratcher can get there, he got Blessing of Freedom again to stay on target. He can silence, potentially, Looney. He uses that the T to immune the incoming silence and is able to avoid this crowd-controlling effect. Then kite across to the opposite side of the map. Choccy Milkman mixing it up, although Wildcard Gaming have a pretty substantial mana lead at 6% dampening. What kind of cooldowns? Ice Block in 30, but Touch of Death is available now. Wildcard Gaming look to make a push. Zpy uses anti-magic shield aggressively with that Raze Abomination, pounding away at Gelu, looking for a kill. Clyde lining up some big holy lights. He's not got a lot of mana to work with. He can definitely not afford to cast Flash of Light at this point. Ratcher is just running at Looney like a Terminator. Looney chi-torpedoing across the map. Ratcher shadow stepping over and reconnecting. What answer do they have? Ring of Peace knocks Ratcher to the side, but he's still stunlocked. Gelu is still firing in. Looney manages to survive the stun. Where is he going to go? Where is he going to run? He's just still out in midfield. Life Cocoon should be good enough for him to survive here. Maybe he's just sitting out here to allow his team more uptime, but he is falling behind. At this point, it's a race to kill Looney or a race to burn down the remainder of Clyde's mana, and it's still too close to call as to whether or not who is exactly ahead in this position. If Looney continues reading these swaps, then I would say that his team are going to be able to close this out, but if he makes even one mistake, one misstep, then I think he is going to lose. Caught into another kidney shot.
Combustion.
There's the anti-magic zone. Good trade. Looney should recover. No overreaction for Wildcard Gaming.
Yeah, Looney does manage to roll away. He's going to be able to top himself off. Now, Ratcher could be in some trouble. And Wildcard Gaming, they've been doing a really good job rotating through the defensive cooldowns. Looney sells his trinket. He has his Fortifying Brew. I think he has some healing elixirs as well. So Looney, as long as he can use his trinket, use the transcendence, he will be able to survive the next swap. Choccy Milkman have sort of lost that kill opportunity onto Looney. They might have to change their attention, but who do they go after? Finally, a little bit of damage over on the Blizzo, but it's Ratcher that's in trouble. Paralysis onto Clyde. Ratcher still in so much trouble. He has the evasion. A big heal comes in from Clyde off the back of that Avenging Wrath that will top him off, but we're at 20% dampening. Things are going to start getting really spicy for both of these teams.
Yes, spicy indeed. Still Looney, though, with some mana, so I would give them the advantage. Hammer of Justice for the engagement. Gelu Baba looks for the kill. Meteor about to land. Huge hit. Looney holding on by a thread. Gets the Life Cocoon, but they shred through it. He's still low on health. Has to deal with multiple interrupts, being counterspell on the mage and kick from Ratcher, and no one else can really absorb those for Looney.
Uh-oh.
Runs into a Ring of Frost. Blizzo locked out of the fight. Zpy now caught in a poly. The all-in on Looney could just end this here and now. Looney's trying to get through the interrupts, but there's still two available. He's too afraid to cast, but he needs to.
Ooh,
they
nice
grip Ratcher
backup
away. They deny the kick. Looney free casts around the corner. Perfect teamwork here. Now Ratcher in
Uh-oh.
Trouble. Blessing of Sacrifice, but may not be enough. Divine Favor, Holy Light doesn't even stabilize Ratcher. The swap onto Ratcher was definitely effective here. Choccy Milkman, they've still got a tiny bit of mana. It's an even fight. Looney looks to avoid Ratcher at all costs. They're going to switch to the Rogue entirely, realizing if they can just keep the Rogue away from Looney, they should be able to win. Looney moves in, stuns, but he stuns too early. 1 second before the death grip. Blizzo is now low on health. Dragon's Breath on Looney. Choccy Milkman mix up their strategy. They Blessing of Protection off the Touch of Karma, I do believe, so its defense is maybe he Buster protects the wrong target. Blizzo now has fortified Brew. It doesn't look like he's going to be dying anytime soon. Ratcher, on the other hand, I'm not sure if that's the same case. It's match point. They face elimination, and Ratcher is looking like he's going to fall. Clyde gets one Holy Light. Ratcher's on the run.
No way.
Looney gets stunned. Blizzo moves over to end Ratcher's fun. How is he still alive at this point? Ratcher holds on. Looney's interrupted. Blizzo actually is not out of the woods just yet. Maybe even a cross kill in this match.
I mean, it's I wouldn't count anything out at this point of the game, but Gelu gets used, touch of death. There's the ice block trade. I think that might have been a waste, but they do get that ice block. Gelu could be in some trouble. Here's a smoke bomb attempt onto Blizzo. Ring of Peace might be able to keep him alive. He flying Serpent Kicks out of there as fast as he possibly can. Fide's almost completely tapped on mana. Looney's tapped on mana. We're at 30% dampening. Blizzo wins some trouble. He doesn't want to overcommit with no Trinket. He's got no Touch of Karma. Diffuse Magic really all he has, but they have to keep the aggression up. Gelu is really vulnerable. Double Leg Sweep comes in from Looney. That was really nicely done. Ratcher and Clyde both Trinket out of that. Here's the Kidney Shot on Blizzo. They have to survive. He has the Fortifying Brew. Is this going to be the miracle kill? Blizzo, he portals out of line of sight. Ring of Peace denies any sort of follow-up damage from Ratcher, and I think Blizzo might be able to hold on. He's still not topped off.
1 second.
Polymorph, he's got the Touch of Karma. He uses it. They're going all in on Gelu. Can he survive, Sid?
I can't believe Clyde is still healing with how much mana he's left in the tank. Divine Shield sacrifice, but it's not ultimate, so Gelu will still be taking some damage. Maybe it's just enough. Z-Pi lobbing out some Death Coils, moving forward, looking to end this game. There's really nothing left for him. How is he still alive on 1% health? And they're both stunned. There's That's no it. Way. Gelu falls, valiantly fought by the Choccy Milkman.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.